In the continuation of the lecture series Introduction to Statistics, today we will discuss classification, tabulation and frequency distribution. At first we discuss about classification. Classification is the process of arranging data into sequences and groups according to their common characteristics or separating them into different related parts. For example, applications received for a particular post by Uttarakhand government may be confusing. To avoid this confusion, candidate may be classified according to their qualification. Qualification, sex, age, etc. The basic idea behind the classification is that the objects with similar nature of character should be grouped together. Object of classification. Broadly, there are six chief objectives of classification. To present the facts in a simple manner. To highlight items which possesses or do not possesses certain attributes or qualities. To provide help in making comparison between items. To find out mutual relationship between certain measures and their effects. To present the data in a manner which is suitable for further treatment. To serve as a foundation for sound judgment and solid conclusions. Basis of classification. Statistical data can be classified according to their characteristics. These are of two types. First is descriptive data and second is numerical data. Descriptive data. Some of the characteristics are not capable of numerical expression. For example, honesty, blindness, deafness, etc. These are qualities which cannot be measured. They are descriptive in nature and are obtained only by counting. This type of classification is also called qualitative classification or classification of attributes. Next, numerical data. These are the characteristics on which some numerical measurements can be taken. For example, weight, height, production, marks, etc. This type of data is called quantitative data, and the quantitative phenomenon under study is called variable, and hence this classification is called classification of variables. There are two types of variables. First, discrete variables and other is continuous variables. First, descriptive variable. The value of the variable differ from one another by exact magnitude. That definite breaks are visible between the different item. For example, number of books in a library, number of male members in a family, number of table in a office, etc. It takes integral values such as 1, 2, 3, etc. Continuous variable. A continuous variable is one which assumes all values within the interval. That is, no definite breaks are visible in this type of series. Age, height, weight, temperature are some examples of continuous variables. Next topic is different modes of classification are chronological classification. In such a series, time is main factor according to which data are arranged. For example, production of sugarcane in the country over a period of time. That is called chronological classification. Next, geographical classification. Classification is according to place, area or region. For example, number of listed consumers, goods, companies in different countries. Next, qualitative classification. Data are classified according to the attributes of the subjects or items. For example, qualification, sex, color, etc. Quantitative classification. Data are classified according to the magnitude of the numerical values. For example, age, income, height, weight, etc. Next topic is tabulation. It is the process of presenting data collected through survey, experiment or record in a row and column so that it can more easily be understood and can be used for further statistical analysis. Objectives of tabulation of data. There are some objectives of tabulation data. Number first, to clarify the object of investigations. Next, to reduce complexity of data. Next, to economize space. Next, to depict the relation among data if it exists. Next, to facilitate analysis of data. Next topic is frequency distribution. Frequency may be defined as the number of individuals having the same measurement or lying in the same measurement group. Frequency distribution is the distribution of frequencies over different measurements. Frequency distribution may be of two types. First, discrete frequency distribution. Next, number two, continuous frequency distributions. Methods of construction of discrete frequency distribution. The following steps are taken. Number first, a table with column is prepared. In first column, all the values of the variable are written in ascending order, starting from the lowest to highest. Number two, we go through the values of the given data and insert a daily marks against each value of the variable. If this value again occurs in the data, tally marks is again inserted. For the sake of convenience, we use for and cross methods, that is, after four tallies, fifth tallies is crossly drawn, that is this. First four, then cut. We count number four tallies with respect to each value of the variable and place it in the third column made for frequency. For example, the number of members in each family were recorded The figures for 25 such family are given below. Suppose we have 25 number of families. Numbers are 0, 4. Numbers are in this table. 0, 4, 2, 3, 1. 1, 2, 0, 5, 3, 4, 1, 2, 0, 2, 2, 1, 0, 4, 3, 3, 2, 1, 0, 4. Express the data by discrete frequency distribution. We form the following table with three columns. Okay. Number first. From the table, we see that the number of zeros 1, 2, 3, 4, the number of zeros are 1, 0 is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Similarly, from the table we see that the number of members 0 is coming 5 times, 1 is coming 5 times and so on. Then we prepare a table for discrete frequency distribution. These are the three column table. Number of members 0 in ascending order 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Tally marks 0 is coming 5 times, 1 is coming 5 times, 2 is coming 6 times, 3 is coming 4 times, 4 is coming 4 times and 5 is coming 1 times. Then its frequency, third column is called frequency table. That is 5, 5, 6, 4, 4, 1. This is basically discrete frequency distribution. And the number of total frequency n is equal to 25. Next, method of construction of continuous frequency distribution. For a continuous frequency distribution, it is necessary to understand the following technical terms. Class interval. This name has been given to each group in which the range of the variable is divided. Next, class limits. These are the values of the class interval. The minimum and maximum values are called the lower and upper class limits. Magnitudes. Next is magnitude. The difference between the upper and lower class limit is called magnitude. Mid value. The mid value is that value which lies halfway between lower and upper class limits. For example, in a class of continuous type 40 to 50, then their mid values is 40 plus 50 divided by 2. That is equal to 45. Class interval can be formed according to two methods, inclusive method and other is exclusive methods. Inclusive methods. in this class interval, both the limit of the class are included. The class may be of type 40 to 59, 59, 60 to 79, etc. Both limit exist, lower limit and upper limit. Okay. Next is exclusive class interval या exclusive method. Exclusive method is that is under this method the upper limit of one class interval is the lower limit of the other. The class may be of type 40 to 60, 60 to 80, 80 to 100, etc. That is called exclusive methods. Next topic is cumulative frequency distribution. In cumulative frequency distribution, the cumulative frequencies are obtained by successively adding the frequency in the distribution. This is the number of observation corresponding to less than or more than or equal to a specified values. Okay. Thanks for hearing me. We will discuss next day with new topics.